Mathematics gives us hope that every problem has a solution. It's not about numbers and equations, it's all about understanding. So here we are to celebrate Max Day of our school. Prayer is something that we learn, and it is also a gift from the God. Let me invite Meenakshi for the prayer.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy will come to make you new? The child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy has gave sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy has stopped storms with his palm? Did you know that your baby boy will come to make you new? The child that you are holding will come deliver you. Mary, did you know?
Okay. Thank you, Meenakshi. Next, I would like to welcome Janaki for the welcome speech.
Math is not a number, nor an equation. It is all about understanding it to the purest. I welcome you all to our Mathematics Day today. So, what is Mathematics Day and why is it celebrated? Mathematics Day is celebrated on 22nd December in India every year to mark the birthday of the great legendary mathematician Srinivasa Ramanuja, who was born on 22nd December 1886. Thus, to recognize his great contribution to mathematics, our government declared his birthday 22nd December as National Mathematics Day all across India. So, I would like to thank all the people who have put in their hard work in this day to make it a grand success and a reality. Now I would like to welcome our chief guest, Neha Agarwal, who has an MSc in Mathematics and a BA in Children Counseling. Thank you, ma'am, for being part of our great day. Your presence has made it wonderful. And now I would like to thank our principal, Shamaru sister, and our Jyothira sister, who is with us on every rise and fall of our life. Thank you for becoming a part of our life. You have influenced us a lot. Thank you for giving an opportunity too. And I would like to thank my teachers, parents, friends, everyone who are making this day a grand success. I would like to thank everyone once again for making this day memorable. Let your talents cherish more beautifully like cherry blossoms. Thank you.
Thanks, Janaki. Let me invite Mrs. Neha Agarwal for the inaugural address.
Good morning, children. Do you know what are we celebrating today? Today we are celebrating National Mathematics Day. There is one more Mathematics Day which comes in March on 14th of March. That one is International Mathematics Day. Today, we are celebrating our National Mathematics Day. Our government announced 22nd of December as our National Mathematics Day in 2012. This was announced to honor our great mathematician, Srinivasa Ramanujan. Srinivasa Ramanujan was born in 1887 in Tamil Nadu. He was a math genius from the childhood. Though he could not complete his formal education. Why he could not complete? Because he was not good in other subjects. So he studied mathematics on his own, and by the age of 13, you will be surprised to know, he mastered entire trigonometry. And he kept on proving results and theorems, and he used to write all those results in his notebook. Entire world is using those results and theorems, and some of them are so complex that even today mathematicians are trying to know how could he prove it. You will be wondering why the proof is not there. The proof is not there because Ramanujan used to solve or derive all these results on a slate with the help of a chalk. And once it is derived, then he used to write it in his notebook. So this notebook is very important, and it is kept in a library in Cambridge. You may wonder, the mathematician is Indian, why notebook is preserved in Cambridge? That's another interesting story. When he was doing all this work, he was solving, he was deriving results, he used to show his work to other people. But nobody was able to understand his findings, and they were not giving him any credit or any importance or using those results. So what he started doing, he sent his work to the mathematicians working abroad. And there was one mathematician named G.H. Hardy who could relate with the work, who understood that these results are very, very important. So he called him to Cambridge. After reaching Cambridge, the person, Mr. Ramanujan, who could not do 10th or 12th or graduation in India, so he did his graduation in Cambridge and he continued working there. Unfortunately, he died very young at the age of 32. Otherwise, he would have given a lot more to the world of mathematics. Now today, to honor his work and to honor the man himself, you all please go and research more about him and his work. You will find many interesting things, like why the number 1729 is important, what is unique in the number. You may come across that while adding positive numbers, you may get the sum as negative. So all these interesting things you will find once you research about him. Please do so. That will be our true celebration of National Mathematics Day. Thank you all.
We are extremely grateful for your words, ma'am. Next, I would like to welcome Sister Alphonsa Matthew, MSNI. She is the Assistant Professor and Vice Principal of St. Thomas College, Thrissur. I welcome you, Sister, to give this occasion with few words.
Hello, my beloved children. First of all, let me wish you greetings of this National Mathematics Day 2021. This is the second consecutive year I am addressing the budding mathematicians of Nirmalamada Central School, AI, on the occasion of National Mathematics Day. As you are aware, today we commemorate a world-renowned mathematician, and it is none other than Srinivas Ramanujan, a proud Indian soul. I think the life and story of Ramanujan must be a great inspiration for all of us. He lived only for 32 years on this earth, but Ramanujan independently compiled nearly 3,900 mathematical results. It is something great. Srinivas Ramanujan was one of the most famous mathematical wizards who made important contributions to the field of advanced mathematics. He was born in 1887 in a remote village in Tamil Nadu. In his college days, he always performed extremely well in mathematics, but failed in non-mathematical subjects due to negligence, as he was too busy studying mathematics. In 1910, Ramanujan met Deputy Collector V. Ramaswamy Iyer, who founded the Indian Mathematical Society, wishing for a job at the revenue department where Iyer worked. Ramanujan showed his mathematics notebooks. He was amazed by his knowledge in mathematics. He referred him to Professor G.H. Hardy, University of Cambridge, England. Recognizing Ramanujan's work as extraordinary, Hardy arranged for him to travel to Cambridge. To make the story very short, the mathematical legend had joined the Trinity College a few months before the First World War. In 1916, he was awarded the Bachelor of Science degree. The next year, he was elected to the London Mathematical Society. In 1918, he was elected a Fellow of the Royal Society for his research. There are so many honors followed by him. But in 1919, due to ill health, he compelled to return to India, where he died in 1920 at the age of 32. Ramanujan credited his substantial capacities to divinity. And once he said, "An equation for me has no meaning unless it expresses a thought of God." Yes, his professor G.H. Hardy once said, "Suppose that we rate mathematicians on the basis of pure talent on a scale from 0 to 100, I give myself 25 and for Ramanujan 100. Such a luminary was genius Srinivas Ramanujan. Let's feel proud of this great Indian soul. I'm sure among you, there will be many Ramanujans. Yes, you are the hope of this world, future of this nation, and star of the society. Yes, you should be proud of your family. Yes, chase our own dreams with passion. I wish you all a great success. I'm happy to declare the National Mathematics Day 2021 of Nirmala Mata Central School, EYAL, inaugurated. Thank you, Vanador. Wish you a Merry Christmas."
We appreciate your words, sister. Thank you. Next, I would like to welcome our dear students to showcase their activities.
A warm welcome to all. I'm Aina Mary Gleason from Class 2. Today I'm here to speak about few great Indian mathematicians. The first one is Aryabhatta. Aryabhatta was born in Kerala and lived from 476 AD to 550 AD. He was the first of the major mathematician and astronomer from the classical age of Indian mathematics and Indian astronomy. Aryabhatta worked on the place value system using a test to signify numbers and stating qualities. He was the one who deduced the approximate value of pi, which he found it to be 3.14. For his outstanding works and contribution to mathematics and astronomy, India's first satellite was named as Aryabhatta. Brahmagupta. Brahmagupta was born in Rajasthan and lived from 598 AD to 668 AD. He was a famous mathematician and astronomer. He wrote a book, Kanda Kadegam, which deals with mathematics. He has given easy methods to write square root in his book and special contribution in the field of geometry. He was the first to explain how to use numeric zero and negative number in mathematical calculation. Srinivasa Ramanujan. Ramanujan was born on 22nd December 1887 in Erode, Tamil Nadu. He is considered to be one of the most talented mathematicians. He made great contribution in number theory, continuum fraction, and infinity series of pi. 1729 is called Ramanujan's number. 1729 is the smallest number which can be expressed as the sum of two different cubes in two different ways. Bhaskara. Bhaskara, an Indian astronomer and mathematician, helped to disseminate the mathematical link of Aryabhatta. He was the one who declared that any number is divided by zero is infinity, and that the sum of number and infinity is also infinity. He is also famous for his book Siddhartha Shiromani. Thank you.
All, my name is Edwin Williams. Today I'm going to tell time table. 1 1 2 1 2 3 1 4 5 1 5 6 1 6 7 1 0 7 8 1 8 9 1 9 10 1 0 10 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 19 20 21 22 23 24 25 26 27 28 29 30 31 32 33 34 35 36 37 38 39 40 41 42 43 44 45 46 47 48 49 50 51 52 53 54 55 56 57 58 59 60
Happy Mathematics Day. Good morning to all. My name is Akshay Sudhi from UKGB. Maths makes a life orderly. Maths helps every problem have a solution. Maths is just not understanding but doing it. It is all about addition, subtraction, multiplication, addition. Everything around it is mathematics. For example, we cannot go shopping on mathematics, as we don't know how to count notes. To conclude, mathematics is a universal language you all should know. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Catherine C. from First Day. I'm going to do in this math wheel addition of two digits number. The first example is 5 plus 11 equals 16. 6 plus 1 equals 7. 7 plus 8 equals 15. 9 plus 7 equals 16. 8 plus 3 equals 11. 10 plus 5 equals 15. 8 plus 6 equals 14. Thank you.
The laws of nature are but the mathematical thoughts of God. Respected principals, teachers, and my dear friends, Srinivasa Ramanujan was the world-renowned Indian mathematician. He is also known as the man who knew infinity. This great mathematician was born on December 22nd at A Road in Tamil Nadu. His birthday is being celebrated as National Mathematics Day. Definitely, we can say that Srinivasa Ramanujan was a mathematical genius in the world. He made numerous contributions in several areas of mathematics, especially number theory and infinite series. His talent and efficiency was recognized by G.H. Hardy, who arranged for him to be a student at Cambridge University. No doubt, the seeds from the Ramanujan's garden have been blowing on the wind and have been sprouting all over the landscape. By this, I'm concluding my words. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Hi, friends. I'm Kida Soni M. I'm studying 40. Here is a simple presentation of a multiplication wheel. That is, this wheel will help the multiplication tables very easily. See this multiplication wheel? Here we can see the digit 5. 5 ones are 5. 5 twos are 10. 28 again. 5 threes are 15. Isn't it quite interesting? Yeah. 5 fours are 20. 28 again. 5 fives are 25. Again. 5 sixes are 30. Again, 28. 5 sevens are 35. Rotate again. 5 eights are 40. Again, rotate. 5 nines are 45. Rotate again. 5 tens are 50. We can rotate again. 5 elevens are 55. 5 twelves are 60. In the same way, we can study the multiplication tables very easily. It is very nice and simple to understand. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Nirchara and I'm from Class 6B. Today, I'm here to tell you how to make a clinometer. A clinometer is an instrument used for measuring the angle of elevation and the angle of depression of an object in order to find heights and distances. We can use a clinometer to measure the heights of tall things that we can't possibly reach to the top of, like flagpoles, buildings, trees, etc. Now I will show you how to use a clinometer. First, we measure the distance between the clinometer and the building. It is 30 cm. Next, we will measure the length of the clinometer. It is 18 cm. Next, we will find the angle of elevation by rotating the protractor of the clinometer and look to the top of the building through this hole. Here, angle of elevation theta is equal to 50 degrees. AB is equal to PQ is equal to 30 cm. PA is equal to QB is equal to 18 cm. We know that tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So, tan 15 degree is equal to PR by PQ. Tan 15 degree is equal to 0.2679. Height of the building is equal to PR plus PA. Therefore, height of the building is equal to 8 plus 80, 26 cm. Thus, we have found the height of the building. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Flavia Chitripalli. I'm studying in 4th standard. Today, I'm going to show you a calculated trace for 3-digit numbers, addition and subtraction. All the numbers start from 0 to 9. For addition, we go forwards. And for subtraction, we go backwards. So now let's start with addition. The question is 364 plus 109. In the one space, it is 4. So we will keep it at 4. In the 10 space, it is 6. So we will keep it at 6. In the 100 space, it is 3. So we will keep it at 3. Now we need to add 109. In the 1's place, it is 9. So we will go forward 9 steps because it is addition. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It raised 3. It closed 0. So we will put 1 step forward in the 10th place. Now, in the 10th place it is 0. So it will not go forward. In the 100th place it is 1. So it will go 1 step forward. And the answer is 473. Now let's move on to subtraction. The question is 892 minus 781. In the 1 space it is 2. So we will keep it at 2. In the 10 space it is 9. So we will keep it at 9. In the 100 space it is 8. So we will keep it at 8. Now we will subtract 781. In the ones place, it is 1. So we will go backwards one step because it is subtraction. In the tens place, it is 8. So we will go backwards 8 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In the hundreds place, it is 7. So we will go backwards 7 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And the answer is 111. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ameraj. I am studying in 6th day. Today I am going to solve this 3 Rubik's Cube. This is 3x3, 2x2 and pyramid. So first I am going to start with this 3x3. So let's start.
However, the majority of teenagers question the importance of math. Still, it is one of the most crucial subjects for us to study. Most students are unaware that math is not just a part of many of our disciplines, but it's a part of our everyday life. So, first I'm starting with thanking everyone who remembered me for this opportunity. Today, we've gathered up to celebrate Maths Day. And so, I thought today I could just speak about mathematics and its importance in our daily lives, as this would be the best day for it. Mathematics is needed almost everywhere, be it engineering, science, or other technological disciplines. Indeed, science as well as technology would not exist without math. In order to analyze data, recognize certain patterns, and prove facts, one needs to apply math. Only then we can understand complex information. There are many students who think that math is a tough nut to crack, but I could just say that if we try to find math in our daily lives, we could just find the subject a lot more easier and we could just get attracted and addicted to the subject. We can find math all over the place. The quantity of what we eat, the dimensions of the wheels of our bicycle, and so we could find math everywhere. Since the 17th century, mathematics has been indispensable and adjunct to the physical sciences and technology. And in more recent times, it has assumed a similar role in the quantitative aspects of life and sciences. In many cultures, under the stimulus of the needs of practical pursuits, such as commerce and agriculture, math is developed for beyond basic counting. Math is as old as civilization itself, but with the ancient Egyptians, Chinese, Greeks, and the Mayans, and Babylonians developing their impressive works using their mathematical knowledge, it is shown in their early documents and artifacts. However, as the centuries passed, the development of maths continued to evolve.
Noted mathematicians from the ancient times up to the 20th century have contributed their discoveries and innovations to math's knowledge of this field. And before anyone want to add something to your knowledge, what can we use instead of the long word that is mathematics? We can find two different suggestions, math and maths. Which one is correct? The only difference between math and maths is where they're used. Math is the word used in places like the United States and Canada, whereas maths is the term used in the United Kingdom, Ireland, Australia, and such other countries. And to sure to say, maths is the most commonly used word, okay?
Hi y'all, I'm Anna. Today is National Mathematics Day. It is celebrated on December 22nd to honor the famous Indian mathematician Srinivasan Ramanujan. He was born in Tamil Nadu in the year 1887. He had a great passion towards the subject maths from the age of 12. He had developed many theorems by himself without any assistance. He had won a scholarship from the Government Arts College for his brilliance towards maths. He has discovered more than 3,900 theorems, which mostly include identities and equations. He had no formal training for mathematics, however, he had made a large contribution towards maths. He died on 26 April 1920 at the age of 32. Prime Minister Manmohan Singh declared his birthday as National Mathematics Day. This day is dedicated to him due to his contribution towards the maths subject to the government of India. Maths is essential for everyone. Maths is the science that deals with the logic of shapes, arrangement and quantity. Maths is all around us in our daily life, including money, art and even sport. Ramanujan has said, "An equation is nothing to me until it expresses a thought of God." Once again, I would like to wish a happy National Mathematics Day to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you all. That was amazing. Next, I'd like to call upon Anjana to express a few words of gratitude.
A very warm and graceful good morning to the most valued Honorable Chief Guest, Miss Neha Agarwal, Management Committee, worthy teachers, parents, my dear friends, and everyone gathered over here. It's my privilege to propose a vote of thanks speech on this very special day and acknowledge the contribution of those who had really worked hard on this day to make this event happen. First, on behalf of Nirmala Mother School, I extend my sincere thanks to God Almighty who made the event a resounding success. With His blessings and grace, we are able to make the day what it was. Next, on behalf of Nirmala Mother School, I would like to thank Miss Neha Agarwal, who spent her time from her busiest schedule to grace the occasion. Her thoughts had really inspired us, and this would surely increase in our future events. Thank you, ma'am, for showing us a new path. An event like this cannot happen overnight. It needs planning and a bird's eye details. I'm short of words to congratulate as well as thank our dear teachers for their involvement and willingness for this whole journey. Thank you to all teachers as well as non-teaching staff for being with us always. Next, I would like to also thank our dear principal, Sister Shan Maria, and our vice principal, Sister Gio Therese, for being the pillars of our strength as well as the backbone of Andramlate's family. Next, I would like to thank our dear parents as well as our well-wishers who encourages us and being the supportive system of each and every child in our school. Thank you to all the parents as well as the well-wishers for being the part of this whole journey. Last but not least, I would like to congratulate as well as thank our little shining stars for their works and their hard work has paid off. Once again, thank you to all of them who worked hard behind this whole journey. Thank you.